of everyone.
Bless fucking her. Get a grip.
Get a grip.
Not you.
Ma.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, everyone. We're Big Topic. Thanks so much for clicking on this video. We're a band from the northeast of England. We usually make music, but now we make YouTube videos, and we are back for another In Our Ears video.
Woo-hoo. So if you've never seen one of these videos before, we just talk about what we've been listening to all month. That is the whole entire concept. It could be new, old stuff.
Just anything that has been catching our attention, local, it can be from around the world. Hopefully we'll have some recommendations that you've never heard of before. We haven't done one for a few months, so this is gonna probably be from like, I think the last time we did was like May. So like June, July, August. If you're new here, please subscribe. It helps us out loads and loads and loads. And I like our content. You might like our content. We have loads of other social medias as well. So give us a follow. It makes all the difference.
Let us know what you're listening to down below as well.
Yes.
Let us know what your recommendations are, because we could always use them, to be honest. We're criminal at repeating the same stuff over and over and over again, so new recommendations,
please,
appreciate it. Here we go. So I've loved Miss Lauren Hibbert.
This wasn't planned, by the way. This is, we just both love Lauren Hibbert.
We've loved her for a long time. She's a massive inspiration for us. She released a EP, Goober, and some of the songs had been like released from a while ago and stuff, and there were two new songs, and it's just class. That's literally all you need to
know. That's the tweet.
Yeah, Lauren Hibbert is really good. She's doing massive stuff now.
She played like, She Met McFly the other day. Shit myself when I saw that.
Yeah. Consistency with releases, and like good releases, like it's just one after another, and this EP is just like, it's just brilliant. And if you've not seen her or like heard about her or anything, I would highly recommend, especially if you like us, if you like what we do, and if that's why you're watching our videos, then you're probably gonna like Lauren Hibbert as well.
Something that's really cool about her in particular is that, like, I think we both struggle with knowing how far we can push like simplicity. A lot of the concepts that we have and the ideas that we have are very like simple concepts, but sometimes it feels dumb to be like, I'm writing a song about this and it's just going to be in plain sight. But like, we do that now, and I think a big reason for that is because we see artists like Lauren Hibbert doing that so well, and it's like she's just saying like what she wants to say.
I think Sugar Daddy, which is a song by Lauren Hibbert, is the perfect example of that. She said publicly that she loves Weezer. And you can tell that about her, and you can tell that we love Lauren Hibbert. So it's like all one big cycle of inspiration. The way we say goober, I'm sure, is how she wanted it to be said. Goober.
How would she say it? Like,
goober.
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 Goober. But we're like, goober.
Lauren Hibbert, goober.
The first thing that I want to talk about is from an artist that I've already spoken about in one of these videos. He's a local artist that is kind of taking it to the next level and has been for like a couple of years, to be honest. His name's Dylan Cartledge. He's like a rapper, bassist, singer. He's so cool. From Redcar.
Lauren Hibbert would say Redcar.
We say Redcar. But he released his debut album, I think that was last month as well, maybe the beginning of last month. The album itself is like the perfect summer album. I have been listening to it constantly. It is so good. And I definitely have favourites, but I don't think there's a bad track on it. No, I don't think there's a skip.
I think it's a really good one to listen to while you're driving, because you don't need to skip. It's just one long masterpiece.
Every song you can hear is a Dylan Cartledge song. They all sound
very... You can spot them on my love.
Yeah. When I think about summer 2021, I think that'll be the album that makes me think of that. Like, when I hear it, it'll take me back to this summer. I didn't say what the album's called. It's called Hope Above Adversity. Oh God.
The next thing I've been listening to all month has been Ola Garland. And again, that's nothing new. I've loved Ola for fucking years. She did these like sessions for some of our new singles. So like, You're Not Special Babe, and Zombie. At the place where she recorded them, she also did these like cool like sessions with a whole band and like some singers and stuff. Dodie was there. And they're just so good.
Like, we call a lot of people genius, but like when we talk about Ola, we really mean it.
You look like a star, you sound like a star.
Must be a star. Part of the reason I've been listening to her so much again is because we bought tickets to see her. Mm-hmm. So we're hopefully going to see her in October, I think it is. The only thing I'm a bit scared about is I think that we're going to seem old.
Oh, yeah. We went to see Dodie together and we were the oldest in that crowd, and aside from the mums and dads.
That was years ago, so we must have only been like 19, 20. Well, now we're going to be like...
ancient. Decrepit.
Mr. Burns and Smithers. In a crowd full of Barton lasers, we are Mr. Burns and Smithers.
Now, the next band that I want to talk about, embarrassingly, once again, is another band that I found on TikTok.
Here we are again. You know that meme? Ah, shit. Here we go again.
It is such a good platform for discovering new bands on. I don't make it any secret that I am a pop punk princess at heart. And like, I feel like I did suppress it for a long time because it isn't like necessarily the coolest music to listen to or anything
like
that.
Well, I mean, it was like trendy in like 2007 and like that trend will come back around again.
Yeah.
But like, it's not pop music.
No, it's not. No, but I feel like it is kind of making a resurgence because of like Machine Gun Kelly and Youngblood and people like that who are doing their kind of thing. So the band are called Games We Play, and they're a band, I don't know where they're from in America, like which part, but literally I found them on TikTok because I saw one that went like relatively viral, and it was basically they have all quit their jobs and they've just moved to LA and they're just like becoming
like you do.
They just decided one day they were like, nah, fuck this, and they've moved their entire families there, like their girlfriends have gone with them and everything.
Wow, that's a move.
Honestly, this song that they've released, the guy did a video about what it's about and why he wrote it and stuff like that, and it was basically just felt like a bit of like a failure during COVID when like he hadn't done anything and he was just depressed for months. Katie's never heard this song before, and it's called Deadbeat. I do like their other stuff, but this song particularly, it's got the chorus goes so hard, like it's so good. Sorry everybody, I think it's probably changed the way that the setup is.
But why?
Why are you doing this?
Sorry about that, everybody.
We had a bit of a power cut with the light that we used. If you come for professionalism, then you came to the wrong place. But we move. I can't remember what I was saying. Games We Play.
Yeah.
The song, it follows a very classic pop-punk like formula. It's the kind of song, like, as soon as I heard it, I was like, well, obviously I'm going to follow there.
Yeah. Games We Play is such a TikTok.
Pop-punk name.
Yeah,
isn't it?
TikTok. Like, pop punk hashtag Hayley Williams. I'm here for that.
Like All American Rejects vibes.
That's exactly what it sounds like.
It's more pop than punk.
Yeah. Definitely.
But with the guitars and the accents.
That accent is the thing that makes it. Like, it's very much guitar, like. Yeah, the guitar is anyway, but when you're like, fuck everyone.
Yeah. It's cool that social media puts you in a position to be able to interact with people that you might not necessarily cross paths with.
The next song that I'm talking about is like, of course I'm talking about this song because the singer is my boyfriend. We're really good friends with and in a relationship with.
We are in a relationship with. We're not both with Ryan.
We're like really close with Club Paradise, who, if you don't know who they are, they're a local band. They've been doing stuff for like over 10 years under like a different name. And Club Paradise has been going for a few years, and that's how I met Ryan, that's how I met my partner. And I would be saying this whether we were together or not, because I was genuinely a fan of their music before we got together. And they're like really poppy. They're like 80s inspired, and they released a new single for the first time since last year. They're amazing writers, and this song is my favourite Club Paradise song ever. Like,
it is so good.
And like, obviously I know like all of the words to every single song that they do, because I've, for one, I've seen them so many times live, but also I listen to them recording it because they do it like remotely. And what I really like about it is in the chorus, the like there's a lead line, and I would almost call it like a counter melody. Because like it started as just like, oh, harmony, and then they decided to turn it up in the mix and it became like this completely other, like, different thing. I also like the theming as well, so like some of the lyrics, like, it has like the word devil in it, and I just like the imagery of it. I like the imagery of like the lyrics and stuff, and I think locally as well they are really, really respected.
Yeah.
But like partly because they've been doing stuff for so long, partly because they are genuinely like on another level. Yeah. So their live performance, like the quality of the singles they produce, is just amazing.
We learn a lot from them on like a daily basis. Yeah. As just like because they've got so much experience and stuff like that. The scene that we're in like the northeast of England is just generally such a supportive scene. You don't have to know someone to be like a massive fan of respect them loads. And there's very little like competition and stuff. No. I find so like everyone is just so buzzing that they're putting out what they're capable of putting out.
I've had questions before from like multiple people about like if there is competition between me and Ryan, and it's just so funny to me because
it's
like
weird. What a weird question.
Obviously I want him to be as successful as I think he deserves. I think they deserve the world, all of them do.
But yeah, the song's called Do You Feel the Same. I'll put it on now. Here's one I made earlier.
That is the best Good Paradise song. I know people have other opinions. You're wrong. That is the best one. But I say this, I know that they've got stuff coming, and I know that they don't care if I'm saying this because they hint about it all the time. Mm. The new stuff is also insane. So if you don't follow them, and if you don't follow them on Spotify and stuff, you absolutely should. It's at Club Paradise everywhere, I think. This is Club Paradise.
This is Club Paradise. Yeah. And maybe on Twitter, Club Paradise _ or something. So we have a new queen of pop, everybody. I mean, everyone knows that Sour by Olivia Rodrigo is the album of the year so far. Like, everyone just knows that. Like, it's
I
not
think
my fault.
It's the album of the year.
Yeah.
We're only halfway through. I know that it is.
Like, I can comfortably say that it's going to be in at least my top three at the end of the year. I think she's such a good representation of, like, the next generation of artists coming through. She's cool. She's exciting. Like, the way she looks is amazing. Yeah. Her whole brand. She seems really nice. She'll have been, like, 17 when she wrote these songs. It's and 18 putting them out. It's terrifying. Like, who hurt you?
And I was like upset as a teenager. I could not come out with a masterpiece like Sour.
No. I feel like it's been ages since there's been someone new. Obviously Billie Eilish, but aside from Billie Eilish, I feel like it's been so long. I feel like this is like a real cultural reset. Like,
yeah.
I think prior to that, the only other thing I can think of is like the likes of Justin Bieber and stuff like when we were
but
in secondary
school.
But that was
like when like Miley Cyrus and all of that stuff was happening. But like you say, that's like, they're like older than us, and that was a long time ago now, considering like how quickly things usually move.
Oh,
so good. Some of the lyrics, like, obviously it's cheesy.
Yeah.
Obviously it's a bit like maybe in 10 years time we'll be like, but it's so like reflective of that time in your life. It's like condensed because like obviously it feels so big at the time, and to have it all in an album as an adult, like it feels nostalgic, even though it's like
now
it's just come out. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the next person I'm talking about is Rosalía. She's Spanish, and I know that you're supposed to say it with fancy.
Rosalía.
Yeah. And I just simply can't do that. No. You know Brittany Broski.
Yeah.
So she is obsessed with Rosalía. Look at that album artwork.
Wow.
Open on the screen now. It's actually, she's like an angel. She's really, really
cool.
That is
so cool.
And it's all Spanish, so I don't know what the fuck they're saying. If you're like trying to concentrate on something, but you also want to listen to music, but you can't listen to music that you know too well, that you know the words of, because then you
It'll
end
distract
up.
You.
Yeah. So I really like Rosalía for times like that when I'm like trying to
concentrate. You can't sing along,
something.
She can't speak
Spanish.
Yeah,
because I don't know what she's saying. But she sounds beautiful.
Yeah. Good enough for Brittany Broski, it's good enough for me.
Exactly.
In our charts, there's English music.
Yeah.
That's it. Like, you might get the odd bit of K-pop.
Yeah.
And that's it. Like, and even then, they're forced to sing in English. We are like the most bloody ignorant country ever when it comes to other countries' music.
Yeah.
The next thing I'm going to talk about is band called Bleachers. If you don't know the band Bleachers, you'll definitely know some of Jack Antonoff's writing. He writes with literally everyone in the world. Taylor Swift, Olivia Rodrigo, Carly Rae Jepsen. Literally the biggest names in pop he has written with. I would love to go to a Bleacher's show because I think the show would be amazing.
It would be really good.
It's just good pop music, like have on in the background. Again, another one where I think it's just good for driving because yeah. it's just, it doesn't matter which song, like there's no bad songs.
Yeah.
Everything that you want a pop song to be, it is that. But it's then kind of got the edge of like, Jack Antonoff has a really cool voice. He is absolutely prolific as a songwriter. Wow. It's insane. It's like everything that he writes is amazing, mm-hmm. which is probably not the case. Like, he probably writes a million songs that never go anywhere. But when you have as many hits as him, it's like everything he touches is gold.
Yeah, it just gets stuck in your head. But it is in a good way. But it's like, it's just earworms.
Such earworms. So this song is called I Wanna Get Better, and it's not from the new album, but it's just a song that I've come back to like time and time again. Obviously, there are so many songs about like mental illness yeah. and stuff like that. But I don't think that it's that often that people write about it that candidly.
Yeah, like, and it's, from that perspective as well. Yeah. It's, like, it's not like indulging in the sadness. It's like, I don't want this anymore.
Yeah, like it's not fun anymore. Yeah.
In this month, it's not embarrassing, but it's not what you would expect from me.
No.
I love musicals. It must have been a couple of years ago now. Me and you and our lovely friend Claire went to see Jersey Boys the musical. And since then, I've been obsessed with the soundtrack.
It's such a good musical,
it's
man.
It's so good. And every couple of months, I'll just be like, remember Jersey Boys? And then I'll just listen to the full soundtrack and like sing like Frankie Valli, like horrendously. You know how musical soundtracks are like perfect?
Mm-hmm.
Like everything about them. Orchestrated to the point of perfection, like that's it. And I just love Jersey Boys, and I think that if you get the chance to see it, because I know they tour it all the time.
It's back at the Empire this year.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to go.
Yeah. A lot of the early days of our friendship, a lot of that was centered around musicals. Our love of theatre. We were like crying over Gerard Way and then crying over like Blood Brothers.
Yeah. The vocals that you get in musical theatre, you don't find that anywhere else.
No.
Like the ability that these people have is absolutely.
It makes me emotional.
The way that they stack the harmonies, and then they're just, it's live as well.
So the last thing that we're going to talk about this week is another local artist, and I'm just obsessed with this song. She's put 3, I think, singles out so far. All of them are really good, but this last one that she put out is like, it soundtracked my entire summer, basically. I absolutely love it. I think it's so clever. It's such a clever song. Her name's Lizzie Esau, and the song's called What If I Just Kept Driving. And I think our band are incredible. We've not actually seen them live yet, but we know our band personally. Like, we went to college and uni with a couple of the members of our band, and like, we know how good they are.
Yeah.
So, and she's amazing. She's absolutely incredible. So like, I know how good they are going to be. Again, just such a good chorus. The difference between the verse and the chorus and like the juxtaposition that it all kind of makes together is just, it's so clever. I would never have thought to do something like that. She's very like different. I don't really know any other local artists that sound similar to her.
I can't think of anyone like,
because she's a pop artist, that's what it is essentially, but like this specific brand of pop.
Yeah, she's got her own edge, doesn't she?
Yeah.
I watched a live stream that she did at Polestar Studios, which is like a local recording studios around here, and they've been doing some really cool live streams, and I tuned in. Like, I'd listened to this song, but like, I'd not really like, I didn't follow her on social media or anything, and I was like, I'm gonna watch this live stream to see like how the studio setup is, and then I was like, oh, she's actually fucking mint.
Unbelievable.
Like, she's so good. And since then I've been like obsessed with her as well. I think she's really
I feel like she's like the full package. Like, she looks really cool, she sounds amazing, her songs are there to back it up. And then if you look as well on her Spotify, every release that she puts out has more streams than the last, and that's always a good sign.
That's what you want
to keep people listening, keep people coming back, and this I think is our best by far. Far too cool for us, you know what I mean?
She's on a different level, and also seems like our social media presence, like since I've been following her, she knows like when to hold back,
mm-hmm.
and we don't
we're oversharing.
She's like very like cool online, and we're not like that. I would like to be a friend.
Yeah. And we'll link all of the artists that we've mentioned down below. I mean, if you want to follow Jersey Boys the musical, then you can. But, like, I mean, more so the people that you haven't heard of.
Yeah.
I'm sure Olivia Rodrigo will be really grateful that we've linked her song down below. Let us know what you've been listening to. We would love to hear, and we would love to feature it in another version of this video.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Subscribe.
Do all those things. Please. And hope you have a lovely day, week, year, life, really. Thanks for stopping by.
Love you.
Bye. Bye. Bye.